The Seiser Alm in South Tyrol. Even here, at an altitude of 2,350 meters, wheat is grown in the most adverse of conditions. But this agricultural miracle is thanks solely to the relentless struggle waged by nature inside each and every plant. Plants are constantly exposed to harmful fungi, viruses, and environmental factors such as drought and heat. Even sunlight continuously changes a plant's genetic information. Every day, every plant undergoes millions of mutations. That is nature's key to survival for plants and animals. Although only very few mutations become a fixed element of the plant's gene pool, in the long term, it is only thanks to these changes that new species arise in nature. For example, it is thanks to this mechanism that some 10,000 different varieties of grass are now in existence. Animals and plants have had thousands and sometimes millions of years of evolution time to adapt to changing environmental conditions. What's happening today with global warming is taking place in such a short period of time that wheat, for example, is being put to a very hard test. And it is extremely unlikely that evolution alone will be sufficient to develop the varieties that will be needed in the future. Cultivation of the wheat we know today began more than 10,000 years ago. Its development started with the domestication of Poesi grasses in Mesopotamia and continues to this day. In a number of stages, grasses evolved to high-performance wheat plants, the staple food for billions of people. But now climate zones are shifting at unprecedented speed, leading to extreme weather conditions such as droughts and severe rain periods, even in regions with previously stable climate conditions, a challenge that many of our current varieties of wheat cannot cope with. Of all the major crop species, wheat is by far the most vulnerable to global warming. Models show that a 2-degree rise in temperature by 2050 will lower wheat yields by an average of 20%. Gottesleben in Saxony-Anhalt, Germany, one of 7 new wheat breeding centers worldwide. Bayer scientists are working here to get wheat into shape for future climate challenges. One of the priorities of Bayer's research is trials with heritage wheat varieties. These varieties of wheat are no longer grown in modern agriculture, but some of them have properties that make them more resistant to certain environmental factors than today's high-performance crops.
Wenn wir zum Beispiel Weizensorten aus verschiedenen Regionen dieser Welt.
Crossbreeding wheat varieties from different regions of the world or heritage varieties with our modern high-performance wheats, for example, gives us access to the positive properties of these varieties.
Dadurch können wir die Widerstandsfähigkeit von Weizen gegenüber Stressfaktoren.
We can make wheat more resistant to stress factors such as heat, drought, or disease, while at the same time significantly increasing the potential yields of the crop. In their research work, the scientists use a computer-based procedure called smart breeding, which combines conventional breeding in Bayer's plant breeding sites, such as Gottesleben, with state-of-the-art DNA analysis in the laboratory at the research site in Ghent. The researchers' interdisciplinary scientific work goes like this. In Gottesleben, the high-performance wheat varieties that are used today are crossbred with heritage wheat varieties, or varieties from other regions, using conventional crossbreeding techniques. Once the first crossbred seedlings of the two varieties emerge from the soil, a molecular sample is taken from each plant and sent to the Bayer Research Center in Ghent for analysis. Here, Bayer scientists compare the DNA of the parent generation with the DNA of the progeny grown in Gottesleben, looking for traits such as drought or heat resistance. The characteristics, also known as alleles, are located at very specific positions in the DNA. If the desired alleles are detected in the DNA of the new plant generation, the targeted properties have been passed on. Only plants that have inherited the desired properties are bred further.
Das Smart Breeding versetzt uns in die Lage schneller als jemals zuvor.
Breeding enables us to transfer the positive characteristics of one variety to another faster than even before.
Das ist auch dringend notwendig.
That is something that is urgently needed, given the challenges such as climate change facing farmers today. Despite the new technology in Bayer's research centers, it still takes 8 to 10 years on average to develop a new variety of wheat and bring it to market. A race against climate change to safeguard the supply of food for tomorrow's global population.
Gelingt es uns,
if we can succeed in breeding more robust wheat varieties, we will be able to open up areas of land for wheat growing that currently cannot be effectively used for agriculture. This is the only way that we can meet the growing worldwide demand for wheat in the long term. It may not turn the deserts green, but it is a new opportunity to mitigate climate change and its repercussions on the food situation for the world's population.